will never forget them, nor the last time we saw them, this morning, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye, and slipped the surly bonds of Earth to touch the face of God.
This is the walkway used by the astronauts to climb in the vehicle, and that arm can be put back in place within about 15 to 20 seconds if an emergency should arise.
KRPS, start your pressure
quarter. Roger, welcome.
Thank you, pre-start.
Roger, CPLT is aboard.
Orbiter test conductor has given pilot Mike Smith a go to perform the auxiliary power unit pre-start. Mike has reported back that he will configure switches in the cockpit to put the auxiliary power units in the ready-to-start configuration. Mission Control has transmitted the signal to start the onboard flight recorders. The two recorders will collect measurements of shuttle system performance during flight to be played back after the mission.
US Go for orbiter APU start.
TLP, OTT, perform APU start.
LOX replenish has been terminated and liquid oxygen drain back has been initiated. Main fuel valve heaters on the three shuttle main engines have been turned on in preparation for engine start. The flight crew has been reminded to close their airtight visors on their launch and entry helmets, and a final purge sequence of the main engines is underway. The orbiter aerosurface test has started. The orbiter flight control surfaces are now being moved through a pre-programmed pattern to verify that they are ready for launch. Orbiter ground support equipment power bus has been turned off, and the vehicle is now on internal power.
Let's go for EP-LO2 pressurization.
External tank liquid oxygen pressurization has started, and purging of the shuttle main engines is terminated. Retraction has started of the gaseous oxygen vent hood. And the ground launch sequencer will make a final check to make sure the vent arm is fully retracted at T-minus 37 seconds.
OTC, PLT, caution warning, memories cleared, no unexpected errors.
Copy.
Liquid oxygen ullage pressure checks are underway, and the liquid oxygen tank approaching flight pressure. The liquid hydrogen replenish has been terminated, and liquid hydrogen pressurization to flight level is underway. The vehicle is now isolated from all ground propellant and fluid loading equipment. The hydrogen burn igniters have been armed. These igniters will be fired at T-minus 10 seconds to burn off any residual hydrogen gas. The solid rocket booster flight instrumentation recorders have gone into the record mode. Solid rocket booster engine gimbal now underway. The 51L mission ready to go. T-minus 30 seconds, and we've had a go for auto sequence start. The SRB hydraulic power units have started. Sound suppression water system now armed. T-minus 15 seconds.
T-minus
10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Control program.
Roger, roll, initiated. Challenger.
Good roll program confirmed. Challenger now heading downrange. Engines beginning throttling down now at 94%. Normal throttles for most of the flight, 104%. Three engines running normally, three good fuel cells, three good APUs. Velocity, 2,257 feet per second. Altitude, 4.3 nautical miles. Downrange distance, 3 nautical miles. Engines throttling up, three engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go with throttle up.
Challenger, go with throttle up.
Well, I guess it should probably know by now. One who wanted to fly, I wanted to ride on that arrow of fire right up into heaven.
We have no downlink.
And I wanted to go for every man, every child, every mother of children. I wanted to carry the dreams of all people right up to the stars.
The vehicle apparently exploded.
And I prayed that I'd find an answer there. Maybe I would find a song giving a voice to all of the hearts that cannot be heard. And for all of the ones who live in fear, and all of those who stand apart, my being there would bring us a little step closer together. They were flying for me, they were flying for everyone. They were trying to see the brighter day for each and everyone. They gave us their light, they gave us their spirit and all they could be. They were flying for me, they were flying for me. And I wanted to wish on the Milky Way, that's upon a falling star. I wanted to give myself and free myself and join myself with it all.
We remember Dick Scobee, the commander who spoke the last words we heard from the Space Shuttle Challenger. He served as a fighter pilot in Vietnam, earning many medals for bravery. Later, as a test pilot of advanced aircraft before joining the space program. Danger was a familiar companion to Commander Scobee. We remember Michael Smith, who earned enough medals as a combat pilot to cover his chest, including the Navy Distinguished Flying Cross, three Air Medals, and the Vietnamese Cross of Gallantry with Silver Star, in gratitude from a nation he fought to keep free. We remember Judith Resnik, known as JR to her friends, always smiling, always eager to make a contribution, finding beauty in the music she played on her piano in her off hours. We remember Allison Onizuka, who was a child running barefoot through the coffee fields and macadamia groves of Hawaii, dreamed of someday traveling to the moon. Being an Eagle Scout, he said, had helped him soar to the impressive achievements of his career. We remember Ronald McNair, who said that he learned perseverance in the cotton fields of South Carolina. His dream was to live aboard the space station, performing experiments and playing his saxophone in the weightlessness of space. Well, Ron, we will miss your saxophone, and we will build your space station. We remember Gregory Jarvis. On that ill-fated flight, he was carrying with him a flag of his university in Buffalo, New York. A small token, he said, to the people who unlocked his future. We remember Christa McAuliffe, who captured the imagination of the entire nation, inspiring us with her pluck, her restless spirit of discovery, a teacher not just to her students, but to an entire people, instilling us all with the excitement of this journey we ride into the future.
Mm-hmm.
the chance to dream. It can be done. The promise of tomorrow is real. Children of spaceship Earth, the future belongs to us all. She was flying for me. She was flying for everyone. She was trying to see a brighter day for each and every one. She gave us her light. She gave us her spirit and all she could be. She was flying for me. They were flying for me. They were flying for everyone. They were trying to see a brighter day for each and every one. They gave us their life. They gave us their spirit and all they could be. They were flying. They were flying for me. They were flying for me. They were flying for me.
Today we promise Dick Scobee and his crew that their dream lives on, that the future they worked so hard to build will become reality. Man will continue his conquest of space to reach out for new goals and ever greater achievements. That is the way we shall commemorate our seven Challenger heroes. Dick, Mike, Judy, Elle, Ron, Greg, and Christa, your families and your country mourn your passing. We bid you goodbye. We will never forget you. For we know in our hearts that you who flew so high and so proud now make your home beyond the stars, safe in God's promise of eternal life.